Do you ever wonder how the pros just quickly pick apart the enemy lines and know what's best against the enemy? It's because they know each hero's weaknesses and strengths and can quickly exploit them. Today, I'm going to help you do just that by teaching you the biggest fundamental weaknesses of each hero. My name is Nate, and welcome to Blizzard Guides. This guide is going to go over the many types of weaknesses and counters, so keep in mind that while some of these weaknesses might be big ones, there might also be bigger counters. I'm not perfect and I don't play all heroes equally, so I might not have everything perfect. There are definitely other counters and weaknesses as well, but these are going to be the biggest ones in my opinion. Also, keep in mind that some heroes' weaknesses are very obvious, so if you already knew some of these, just keep that in mind and remember that some are very obvious, and I'm sorry that, you know, you may have already known some of them. Also, before I start the video, I do want to bring up two things. One, we have a Discord that you guys could go check out. We've got a lot of really cool content over there and a super awesome community. Be sure to check out our Discord in the link below. Also, we've just started a Twitter, so if you're looking on updates on this channel or just general meta discussion, be sure to go follow our Twitter in the link below or at @Blizzard_guides. Anyway, I'm going to be starting with the tanks and then go to the DPS and then the support. I'll cover their weaknesses so that you can exploit them, and then I'll also just teach you how to counteract those weaknesses as those heroes so that you can be better on your role. Anyway, let's get into the video. Starting us off is the tanks. We're going to begin with D.Va. D.Va's biggest weakness is just the counterpicks that you can play against D.Va. Some of these heroes on this list are countered by maps, some are countered by other heroes, and some are just countered by comps. D.Va's just work really well in nearly any comp and can be played on nearly any map, so her biggest counters are just the non-projectile heroes and a few select other heroes. Reinhardt and Zarya are really good against D.Va as they can just build up ult and play around Matrix for free. As D.Va, your biggest asset is your defense Matrix, so having an enemy that can ignore DM is your biggest detriment. To work around that, you just need to pick apart the enemy lines and find targets that you can dive outside of the reach of those that ignore your defense matrix. If they can't shoot you, you'll be able to get out of danger while also still being effective at creating space and matrixing enemies that are affected. Also, Junkrat and Reaper are really strong counters since they can easily farm damage off of a D.Va, so also keep that in mind and don't play too close to them if you're playing D.Va. Next up is Orisa. Orisa, like D.Va, is countered heavily by Junkrat and Reaper. Furthermore, she also gets countered by Pharah, Widow, Hanzo, and McCree. Orisa doesn't really play well with burst damage, her giant crit box and her off-tank Roadhog just don't do too well against spammy or high-burst enemies. Her shield also doesn't fare too well against Pharah or Junkrat. In addition to these counters, Orisa just doesn't do too well on maps that are fast-paced or have varying high ground. Orisa is effective when you bunker, but if you have to constantly shift between the high ground and low ground or move quickly, Orisa becomes a slowdown for your team. To mitigate these counters, just play on slower maps as Orisa and don't waste your shields. If you know that your team won't die to the Junkrat spam on your shield, just wait a bit and use a fortify to block the damage that's coming in, and then use your shield later on whenever it's more important to use it. Also, don't replace your shield if it's at max HP, replace it only when it starts getting low. If they have snipers, play spots that force the snipers into uncomfortable angles or angles that only have one good sightline, and then shield that line of sight. Following that, we've got Reinhardt. Ryan just gets countered by fast-moving enemy comps. If you're playing Ryan, you're going to be mobile, but you're not going to be within short distances. If the enemy dives your backline and you are slightly too far away, your backline will just likely take a hit and have a few deaths. He also gets countered somewhat by Pharah and Junkrat spam, but because he can move his shield constantly, a good Ryan isn't necessarily countered by this. To avoid getting countered as Ryan, you simply just have to be aware of when and where the enemy could be diving from, and always be ready to protect your backline when it is necessary. Don't charge in only to have the enemy dive away and kill your Ana. Next up, we've got Roadhog. Roadhog's in a bad state right now, so he is actually just countered by a lot of different things. Shields and burst DPS counter Hog, as well as his lacking mobility. Just like Orisa, his biggest counters are going to be those that beat off of his massive hitbox and crit spot. Anything that plays out of his range will be able to farm him for ultimate, and anything that plays close can usually get enough damage in to build ult quickly. On top of that, his hook is ineffective against shield-heavy comps, making him a very weak tank in his current state. To combat this, you just really need to play a safe mental game as a shield buster, constantly watching out for out of position picks that you can quickly grab with your hook. Don't put yourself in a risky position, you'll only feed ultimate to the enemy team. Coming after Hog is the king of dive, Winston. Winston is really dependent on his jump pack, and as such, his counters really just revolve around crowd control. He can generally be played on any map, so he's going to have a lot of trouble when the enemy has CC, not dependent on what map or comp they have. Brigitte being the obvious example, her stun and flail prevent enemies from getting in deep. Therefore, anything that actually quickly disables him momentarily, or that can break his shield quickly are going to be troublesome for him. If you want to play around these as Winston, you simply just have to really calculate your dives and make sure that you're not diving into a bunch of crowd control. While Zen might look like a tasty target on a Monday, if on Tuesday he hires a Brigitte to keep him safe, you definitely don't want to be jumping in for him. Brigitte plus Discord will melt you. Rather, you should be diving the Ana that they've neglected on a flank and then getting out quickly. CC only works at a close range, so if you get those that are at a long range away from the CC, you'll be fine as Winston. Next up is Hammond. Hammond is exactly like Winston. If you dive in too deep or too quickly, you're just going to get CC'd and killed. Do the same thing as Winston, and you'll be fine. Last but not least in the tank category, we've got Zarya. Zarya's a pretty interesting one. While she definitely has weaknesses such as snipers, Pharah, and big shields, none of those really stand out as a de facto huge counter. Rather, for this one, Zarya's biggest weakness is just a lack of Rein. Zarya can't really be played without a big shield in front of her constantly feeding her charge, which is why Reinhardt Zarya is so common. Zarya can be run with dive, but it's not that effective, and there are many more replacements for her in a dive composition. Therefore, I'm putting it down as a lack of Rein. You have to have a Rein constantly giving Zarya charge and allowing her to get damage in. Otherwise, you're just going to be stuck out, not doing much, and not having bubbles for your team. If you see a Zarya without a Rein, just wait for her bubbles to go on cooldown and then focus her down. She'll die easily. If she doesn't have charge though, you don't even need to make her a priority. If nobody's feeding her charge, she's literally not going to do anything at all, since she'll only be doing as much damage as a Moira. Next up, we've got the DPS category. This one obviously is a bit longer than the other two, so bear with me. Starting us off, we've got Bastion. Bastion's biggest weakness is just his need to be stationary. If you can have anything that can spam him, he's not going to be able to do anything about it since he can't really escape it. Junkrat, Pharah, ranged heroes, and mobile heroes are going to shred through Bastion. You really need to coordinate as a team to be able to run an effective Bastion. If you can shut down these counters and prevent any incoming damage from reaching your Bastion, you'll be able to get him to do a lot of work. Otherwise, if you have to engage on the enemy with a Bastion, setting him up is going to be your next biggest problem. Just make sure that you play in corners and in angles that it makes it difficult for the enemy to jump you and get to you, or that forces them into an uncomfortable position or to overextend to actually get a kill on you. Bastion can be effective in this spot, but you need a team that can play around you as Bastion to not be countered so heavily. Following that, we've got Doomfist. Doomfist's biggest counter and weakness is himself. While one might assume that I'm talking about the various bugs that we've seen with Doom, I'm actually just talking about his ability to feed so much. Pretty much any CC is super effective against Doomfist, but that is only true if you have an inexperienced Doomfist. Doomfist has to expend escape abilities to get into the fight, so if you don't carefully manage your abilities and thoughtfully use them, you're going to get into the fight and immediately die to the amount of just damage that the enemy can output while you're stuck without a way out. You have to always be ready to escape at a moment's notice, so analyzing the threats posed to you and what you have to do to escape is necessary to mitigate the feeding that you can do as Doomfist. If you're playing against a Doomfist, just try and kill him whenever you see him use all of his abilities. If a Doomfist uses punch, slam, and uppercut to get into the fight, he can't do much to you for about 4 seconds, which is enough time to kill him then and there. After Doomfist, we're going to look at Genji. Genji's in a similar place as many other dive characters. Crowd control abilities is always going to be a big counter to mobile characters, so it's obvious that Genji just gets ripped by anything that can limit his movement. If you see an Orisa, Hog, Rein, Brigitte, Mei, or more, you're just going to hide and really not interact with them to actually counter them and not get destroyed by them. It's difficult to be effective when you're getting pushed around. Go for those that can't really CC you very easily or that don't have autolock. Killing McCree's, Ana's, Zen's, soldiers, and more are what you want to be doing. Don't dive Brigitte just because you think that you can escape. Followed by Genji, we have his brother Hanzo. Hanzo isn't really countered heavily by maps or specific comps, so his weakness is more so just getting dove quickly. While he does have the double jump, if you can catch him with this rapid fire down, he's going to be quickly killed provided that you can dive him properly. He can't really do much close range burst damage without that ability, so you can easily kill him and then just get away with it. As Hanzo, just be mindful of when you use storm arrows and be aware of when you might get dove on, and save those rapid fire arrows for whenever you think that you might get jumped. Next up is Junkrat. Junkrat's two biggest weaknesses are open maps and Pharah. Pharah is obvious, so I'm not going to be explaining that one, but the more critical counter is open map types. If you can't spam hallways and small rooms, you're just going to have to rely on predicted shots and a bit of luck to actually get kills with your bombs. On top of that, hitting multiple targets is nearly impossible out in the open. To mitigate this, just try and force the enemy positioning into close quarter rooms or play barrel stuffing into the enemy tanks, dealing bulk damage to shields and bodies as you go. Following that, we've got McCree. McCree's biggest weakness is his mobility. He can't escape like some of the other heroes can, so just being able to jump him quickly and get out is what is needed to kill a McCree. McCree can't flash and kill more than one target, and if they're a tank, that's also just not really possible. Therefore, jumping a McCree and getting him off high ground is enough to counter him. As McCree, you really have to rely on instinct and your team to get out of situations like these, and don't put yourself too far away from your team so that you don't get insta-gibbed away from the safety of your backline. Halfway through all of the heroes, we've got Mei. Mei's biggest weakness is her range. While she does not have damage falloff, she still can't be really effective when it comes to long range battles, as she is just very inconsistent. Coupled with the fact that her walls are really only useful at a close range, she gets melted by any ranged enemies. Her utility solely lies in the close range usage of that wall. If you're on Mei, try and play where you can divide the enemies up and CC with freeze, and make sure that you're aware of each line of sight and play around corners. Never come face to face with the enemy, always be right around the corner or flanking slightly to the side. Coming up at number 15 on this list is Pharah. Her counters are very obviously hitscan. While Pro Pharahs will have you believe that she isn't countered by hitscans, the reality is that if you aren't in the top tiers of the ladder, you probably won't be able to use this concept. Hitscans can totally still shred through a Pharah in addition to D.Va's. Pharah's flight is easy to predict, meaning it's easy to kill as a hitscan. If you're on Pharah, just don't ever peek the same angle twice, and don't stay in the open too long. Also, try and surprise the hitscan by concussion blasting your way in, and using boosters to get massive speed to land a direct before they even acknowledge your presence. After Pharah, we've got Reaper. Reaper is another pretty obvious one. His weakness is just his range. Reaper can't really move up quickly like some of the other heroes in the game, so he's somewhat predictable if you're not already a pro Reaper. If the enemy has anything that can play at mid-range comfortably, he's going to get quickly deleted. Just play flanks and never let the enemy see you until you're on top of their heads, and you'll absolutely shred as Reaper. Reaper gets exponentially worse as his range increases, so minimizing that range is ideal. Next up is Soldier 76. Soldier is a lot like McCree. Getting dove quickly and not playing with your team is going to be a large problem for you. However, on top of that, armor is also a big problem for soldiers. Armor cuts soldiers' damage nearly in half, so playing around that is a must. Use rocket to remove any armor, and playing near your team is necessary to stay effective as soldier. After Soldier, we've got Sombra. Sombra's biggest weakness is her damage. She can't really do that much as she's rather slow-paced. You really have to get as much utility as possible out of Hack to be effective as Sombra with mediocre aim. Once you're at GM plus levels, then it becomes a question of other stuff. At every other rank though, it is 100% her damage that is her weakness. Make sure that you're hacking as much as you can and focusing targets that can't escape or that have low health pools, rather than trying to kill all of the mobile stuff that you definitely won't be able to outdamage. Next up is Symmetra. Like a lot of other heroes, her weakness is in her range. On top of that, her turrets and teleporter are easily killed, making her ineffective as a utility DPS. Killing her turrets is easy, and then destroying teleporter and staying away from her is even easier. With Sim, you need to simply place turrets in spots that are most difficult to deal with, that only affect 1 to 2 enemies, rather than actually the entire bunch of the enemies. On top of that, you also need to close the gap as quickly as possible to be effective, and use the teleporter in spots that the teammates might be able to use, but that the enemy won't really easily be able to predict. Don't definitely put them behind them or right in front of them, they'll almost definitely destroy them. After Sim, we've got another builder, Torbjorn. Torb's a lot like Bastion. His counters simply spam and outrange him to win fights. You can quickly destroy Torb's turret with burst and kill Torbjorn with the crit box that is his entire body. Torb simply needs to be aware of the dangers of his positioning and place turrets in a way that cause the enemy to overcommit to killing it or that are naturally protected by the cover of your team. Also, constantly moving the turret is a good idea. Second to last, we've got Tracer. Tracer falls under the same weakness category as all of the other dive heroes in the game, CC. You've got to follow the same rules as the other dive heroes and you'll be fine. Last but not least in the DPS category is Widowmaker. Widow's biggest weakness is flanks. Widow has to focus and pay attention to one very specific thing that she's scoped into, meaning that she's very susceptible to anything coming from the sides or behind. If you can catch a Widow off guard, she doesn't have many damage options, and if she's on high ground, there's not too many places for her to hook away to that you can't already readily access as a flanker. On Widow, you really just need to always have an escape ready with that hook and constantly be checking your sides to make sure that you don't get melted by the enemy. If you know that you might get dived in a little bit, don't use your hook and just save it and be ready to escape to a specific spot that you already have planned and make sure that you don't get caught off guard on the sides. Alright, we're on the home stretch now, coming up into the support category. Starting us off is Ana. Ana gets destroyed by anything that really can just jump her quickly. While she does have options in the form of anti and sleep, those are on a high cooldown and are heavily skill based, unlike Briggs' stun. She can quickly get flanked and shut down easily as she also must just focus down the scope like Widowmaker. Mobility based heroes are what counter Ana well. If you're playing Ana, make sure to be aware of the enemy and where they're coming from, always have your abilities ready out to help you, and always make sure that you're near someone that can help you out. Don't ever get caught off guard by yourself, and you'll do pretty much fine as Ana. She's a very viable hero in terms of dealing with flankers, you just really have to rely on your team and know that you can't do it by yourself like you could maybe do with Brigitte. Speaking of Brigitte, next up is Brigitte. Briggs' biggest weakness is her range. She can't really do anything in the mid and long range, so spamming her with Junkrat, Pharah, or outranging her with Widow, Hanzo, and McCree are good options. On top of that, she can't really manage big health pools or heavy heals as well, so using either in tandem with spam or range is optimal. If you're on break, just try and play on corners and right by your tanks, and also be aware of the range and make sure that they can't see you until you're already picking up kills on those that are immobile on their team. After Brig, we've got Lucio. Lucio's biggest weakness is his just lacking heals. If you can do a lot of burst damage to an enemy with the Lucio, you can quickly gain an advantage. You can also CC him easily if he overextends, which is another weakness of his, similar to Doomfist. As Lucio, just make sure that you're not feeding and protect your main healer to help them heal those that get hit, rather than relying on your lacking heals to bring your allies back to life. If you're only healing people as Lucio and they don't have main heals with them, they're probably going to die just because you can't heal them up quickly like you could with other supports. So always keep that in the back of your mind. This one's a pretty obvious one since Lucio doesn't really necessarily have a direct, huge, big weakness, so this one applies more to people that are in lower ranks. Following Lucio is Mercy. Similar to Lucio, her healing isn't as good as it used to be. Pretty much anything can outdamage her healed targets. If you can get in and deal enough damage to a specific enemy, you can outdamage unlike you could against Ana, Brig, or Moira. When you're on Mercy, make sure that you're healing those that are taking significant damage, healing the squishies if you can, and then also rezzing the safe rezzes that you can get away with. You're not going to be able to outheal any consistent damage, so even stuff like Winston will outdamage a Mercy's healing, so just make sure that you always keep that in mind when you're playing Mercy, or if you're playing against Mercy. Next up is Moira. Moira's biggest weakness is her range. She can't really heal anything that runs away from her, so if you can pull or find enemies that are far away and kill them, you'll be able to counter the Moira effectively. Ana can heal them at range, Brig can burst heal them, Lucio can speed them, and Mercy can res them, but Moira, however, cannot do much about it, as she has to abandon her team and heal that one ally. Get the enemy away as quickly as you can, and you'll counter her pretty hard. If you're on Moira, just stick to your team and bulk heal, and use the orb to heal those that get away, and if you have to, just get close and heal with left click, and then fade out and back to your team. And lastly, the final hero on this list, Zenyatta. Zen just simply has no mobility. If you can dive him, you can shred Zen. Zen can't really peel for himself unless the Zen player is Jojonak, so make sure that you scout out the Zen by himself and jump him quickly. If you're on Zen, just never leave your team. There are very few reasons to be more than 3 seconds away from your team, so just always keep that in mind. Always be ready to call on your team for help, and always be aware of the flankers and where they might come from. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you thought the biggest weakness on this list was, and if you have any other weaknesses that you'd like to bring up in the comments down below, feel free to do that. I'd like to start a discussion on this topic and see what you guys have to come up with. This list is definitely incomplete and it does not have all of the weaknesses and counters, so if you have any interesting ones that you think I missed or left out, be sure to drop those in the comments down below. If this guide helped you guys out or you just enjoyed it in general, be sure to drop a like on this video so that we know that you guys are enjoying the content. And if you really like this video, make sure to get subscribed if you haven't already so that you never miss our tips and tricks videos or our weekly highlight videos. If you're looking to join the Blizzard Guides community, be sure to check out our Discord in the link that's in the description. We'd love to see you there, and we really have a great community there. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Have a nice day. My name is Nate, and this was Blizzard Guides.